Next talk is deformation of accretionary wedges along North Mariana Trench in response to incoming plate variations by Chen Chuanxu.
Good afternoon. Good pleasure to be here. Give an introduction of my research. My name is Chen Chuanxu, and I'm a master candidate to study marine geology and geophysics at the Institute of Oceanology, Chinese Academy of Sciences. The topic of my presentation is the deformation of accretionary wedges around the Manila Trench, northern Mariana Trench. And in response to incoming plate variations, and two fellows from PetroChina, Zhuo Changlian and Yu Yuming, gave me a favor in the seismic data processing. My presentation will follow this outline, and the first part I will give a brief introduction of the geological settings of the geological setting of the research area. Manila Trench is a convergence boundary between the South China Sea plate and the Philippine Sea plate. And the northern part of this trench is complex because it is adjacent to the continental drift of South China. Also, an initial other continental collision zone in the Taiwan Island at the same time. So there are still controversies over the tectonic feathers of this area. For example, the existence of this transform plate boundary, and also the location of the continental ocean boundaries. All these controversies are just pieces of the truth, and they just indicate that the incoming plate at this subduction system is not homogeneous. Based on the seismic interpretation from the dense multiple seismic data and the newly integrated multiple beam seafloor morphology data, we suggest that the incoming plate at this area can divide into three sub areas. The northern part can be treated as a trapped oceanic crust with thick sediment and high pore pressures because of this widespread canyons. And the nature of this crust is the Philippine Sea crust or proto-South China Sea crust. Well, the middle part of this area is a buoyant mass with thin sediment, you can see from this picture. And also the high basement, also the widespread volcanic intrusions. This the nature of this part of a crust is the macro-continent crust, or maybe a transitional crust. We will talk about it, this controversy later. The south part of this area is the normal South China Sea plate with relatively thick sediment. And this division just indicated that the incoming plate is different from north to south, and this leads to the core question of my talk is how this incoming plate variations influence the deformation of the accretionary wedges in this area. And first, we look into the character of the deformation from the seismic imaging, also the seafloor morphology imaging. From north to south, there are two special characters of this area. The first is a low deformation bound at the northern part. So here, it is formed in intense compression settings at the continental collision zone. So it it doesn't make sense firstly, but we will talk about the reason for this character, the origin of this character. And the other special character of this area is the concave trench geometry. Because according to the ping pong and ping pong ball analogy, most of the trenches are involved towards a convex arc shape. So this concave trench may be consistent with the presence of a high seismic relief. The north part, the south part of the deformation is gradually developed folded and the thrust belt. It is a typical result of the normal oceanic crust subduction. And when we look into the seismic data processing, seismic data imaging of this area, due to the complex overriding structure, the imaging is not so well, and it leads to two questions. The first is what caused the huge uplift of this up slope? And the other question is, where does the decollement end? So compared to one seismic profile we collected in the Manila Trench, the seafloor morphology is similar, and also the presence acquisition parameters are also similar. So while in this area there's a subducted seamount clearly imaged, so it is easy to think whether there is a subducted seamount at this area instead of the previous post-stack imaging. We reprocess the same data. Firstly, we use the detailed demultiple processing. And after that, we use the pre-stack time migration. And at this area, there's a suspect event of the subducted seamount. Also, there are also two unexpected results of these two events, here and here. This may be the morphic depths, and this can be evidence to the fact that the incoming plate is a transitional crust. And the pre-stack depth migration result has been working on, not getting. There are many factors can influence the deformation of accretionary wedges, include the sediment thickness, the internal deformation, include the duplex back thrusting, also the back fold, also the autosynchronous thrust. And also the physical nature of accretionary prism and the decollement also can influence the deformation. The other factors include the pore pressure and the slumps that may exist. Some of the factors can be directly identified from seismic data, and the other factors only can be approximately estimated by the mathematical methods. And we're using the factors influence the deformation varies in different subduction rules. And using the newly multiple data and the reprocessed seismic profile, we can look into the relationship between the incoming plate heterogeneities and prism deformation variations. First, at the north part, it is we can explain the low deformation about the formation. That is because the sequence of sediment at this area results in more fluid if held. And the fluid tends to flow through the major fault zones, such as the decollement, and it creates an elevated pore pressure and leads to a decrease of the shear strength. And this will be result in a broader proto-structure and a weak deformation at this area. And the reason of this concave trench curvature is that the sub area B, or in the mid part of the incoming plate, is the internal heterogeneous within this part of oceanic lithosphere, include the difference in age, a difference in age between compared with the north and south. Also, the existing of the seamount, buried seamount, and the buoyant mass. This will influence the strength of the strength and the buoyancy of the descending slab, and will change the rate of the subduction rollback, and ultimately could modify the trench shape. The next part we will talk about the evidence for the subduction of the transitional crust. The evidence from the transitional crust has a character of neutral buoyancy, and also the mafic depths intruded in the oceanic into the crust. The as to the neutral buoyancy, we can find evidence from the gravity, because at this area we can find the higher free air anomaly, and also evidence from the slab angle from north to south. This is the location of A, B, D, E, and the slab angle is more flat, so it implies that the subduct slab is more buoyant. And also the evidence from the seismic processing, the existence of the mafic types make it high possibility that the nature of this part of the crust is the transitional crust. And this comes to the final the conclusion. We separated the incoming plate of North Manila Trench into three units, and we based on the interpretation results for the multiple seismic data and seafloor morphology, and this diversion is consistent with the deformation character of the accretionary wedges, such as the existence of the low deformation belt and the entrance of the trench. Also, the incoming plate variations will result in heterogeneous deformation of overriding plates. Also, possibility give rise to profound change in the style and spatial-temporal distribution of the magmatism and the seismicity of these morphogenic structures. And our precise seismic imaging will provide observation constraints for this subduction. For this subsequent research. And thank you.
Thank you very much. Are there any questions or comments? No. You found the mafic anomaly, and you interpreted this one, and if this anomaly is consistent with some level 3 data?
No, this is because at this area there's a multiples of the seafloor, and after we demulted the seafloor multiples, and these two events become clear, and the reason I interpreted as the multiples because compared with the other areas, it's east of this area. And also a seismic file from Italy. At this area, some people saw the character of this kind of events. So I followed the example over there. There's no evidence, other evidence. So it's just suspected. I was still working on it. Thank you.
Any questions?
Okay, thank you.
Okay.